What a time to be alive, huh?
Yeah.
It's like really hard to believe women or believe victims or believe folks who are. This last piece, however, I'm gonna close this out and then we're gonna have a little conversation. Do y'all mind? Are y'all there? You're out there? Cool. I would love for us to talk a little bit, but I'm gonna read this last piece and pass it over to Adam. So this last piece I wanted to share, it's called A List of Demands. And the story behind this piece is I actually, after just a series of feeling kind of mulled over, I finally just snapped and I wrote this piece in my laptop with no intention of sharing it. And when I was writing it, was just trying to speak things over my life. Like, I'm just not going to be ran over like this ever again. I'm not. And I wrote this as a mantra for myself, something for me to just get out of my system and know. And years later, you might know him, I think he's visited here before, Dennis Smith.
Yeah.
Who was my roommate at the time. We were going back and forth. This is way before National Book Award finalism. But we were going back and forth about sharing poems we hadn't shared before. And I had pulled this one out of the archives and Dinez, they said, you know, why don't you ever read that? I just didn't think it was anything other people needed or wanted to hear. This piece, I offer it to you all as a reclaiming and as a demanding. So I dedicate this to anything or one or thing or one in your life or many in your life that has ever made you feel small. This is a list of demands to them, that thing. You will not waste me. You will not fold me, hide me in your back pocket. You will not lose me at the bottom of your laundry basket. You will not fade my design, dim my light, turn my shine into your shadow. You will not excuse me. You will not draw my figure. You will not figure me out. You will not wrap me in your self-made cellophane ego. You will not suffocate me. I will see through you. You will not confuse me with your pets. You will not pet me like your dog. You will not dog me like we're boys. You will not be boy at your age. You will not drown me in the tide of your temper. You will not outclap my thunder. You will not strike me. You are not lightning. You are not likely to outright swipe me. You will not crack my stone stare. You will not break my glass parts. You will not carve my calluses smooth or hack my smoothness coarse. You will not crash into my drive. You will not ride my success without my permission. I will not be written off as too angry, too feminist, too victim. You will not diminish the light that brought your sinking ship to shore. I stand too tall. You will not swim through me. I will not swallow my ride. You will not wave my coast with dirty feet. You will not pollute me. You will not use me as your clean slate to stain me with your repeated mistake. You will not mistake my kindness as being blinded. I will see through you. You will not deflate me with your bloated sense of self. You will not drain my flame to flicker. You will not dilute my message. I will not water this down. You will not treat me like the child inside you. Abuse me like I did what's been done to you, what you've done to yourself, what she did to your self-esteem, what he did to your mother, or whatever excuse you use to use me. You will love me with every ounce of your weight, or you will leave me with my queendom in full bloom. And whether you wither or grow in your own time, you will not waste me.